Hey y'all, hey y'all, hey, and it is Talk About It Tuesdays. How y'all doing? This was from the funeral. I'm surprised it's still alive, the funeral. Well, I went to the wake. I didn't want to go to the funeral. It's just like I said my goodbye to her at the wake alone. And she looked like she was sleeping. I was so mad that they were going to put her away bad, but you could see all of her moles. And they didn't have like that heavy pasted makeup, and they had some beautiful mauve lipstick on that matched her complexion perfectly. And she looked like she was asleep. She was so beautiful. They laid her to rest so beautifully. And they had a memorial and a repast. It was a lot of people that I don't get along with, their family members, but sometimes family members can be very toxic, and if you watch the video where I was at my grandma's house before she passed and she was looking so sad and despondent, if you look on the wall, it's a camera, and they'll explain everything. I don't need to go into any further detail. And I'm quite sure some of you zoomed in and saw that. And that explains everything. And I don't have to talk about that. All I know is I don't have to worry about stuff like that anymore because she's gone. I don't have to go through gatekeepers to visit with her. I can visit with her in my dreams, through memories, and she can talk to me through those memories, and nobody can take that away from me. About life and about food and the different things that we went through, and they can't take that away from me. They can't take my memories away from me. They took her last moments with just me and her just talking away from me, but they can't take it away from me now. And that's all I have to say about that. I miss my mother dear, but she's with me right here. And on this Tuesday, I mean, it's been a hard couple of months because she's been up and down, and but we all knew that this day was coming. I just didn't expect her to go down as fast as she did because she was so exuberant and full of life and happy and joyful and funny and still like slick at the mouth and not afraid to check you and tell you what the business was. And I love that about her. She was a plain, no-nonsense woman. She said what she meant, and she meant what she said. And if you didn't like it, too bad. She would say, scratch your blank and get glad. And I used to crack up laughing. And she used to always say, I'm blanking this cat. You just hold his tail. I got this. Just so many different saying and hoop alley low and every time she would see a penny at your house, she would pick it up and say, yo, and put it in her pocket. Rosalind remembered that. It was just like all her different sayings. And I have plenty of memories, good memories and bad. But I can honestly say that I've been stressed out for the past few months. I've been eating wrong and just tearing up brownies. I don't know. It's been brownies since Halloween. It's been brownies and Tootsie Rolls. I just been like, I ate that whole bag of candy. The Tootsie Roll with the Tootsie Roll Pops and the Fruit Chews and the dots all in the package. I ate up two of those bags, and I know they were like 5-pound bags. And yes, I gained some weight, but I'm working it off. it kind of, my face kind of went down from the last time. And since y'all saw me, and I'm back on my exercise routine. I haven't gotten on my bike yet, but I will be doing that when I get off of this video. And if you found this channel and welcome. Right now I have one subscriber. And I start back as one. I love Brian McKnight. And welcome. It's just me and you, kid. Whoever you are. So I'm starting over with one. And I don't want to go back on the channel, the other channel, because I have 322 subscribers. And like I said, nobody ever made a comment or, I mean, like, came into any of my lives. That I think I only had two lives before. Nobody gave me condolences. Nobody said RIP. And that kind of hurt my feelings that I have 324 subscribers on that channel. And not one RIP. So I think they're all this new word that they're just ops. And I guess they're the ones that just keep taking my content. So I refuse to put any other content on that channel. And I'm not. I say stuff on the community wall, but I will not be uploading any more videos on that channel. And they can stay there and they can leave. I really don't care. My channel is not about subscribers. It's not about likes. I don't even think the like button does anything for your channel. I don't know why some YouTube content creators be like, up my likes, give me a like, or get out, or I'm stopping this live if I don't get so many likes. That's just like, I don't know. And I don't want to do that to you who's ever watching this channel. I could be just talking to myself, but I don't care. I'm broadcasting myself on YouTube. Yay. And I'm happy to have that platform to be able to do so. And it's not about money. It's not about fame. It's not about fortune. It's about just networking and getting things out and inviting you into my world and my life in real time, in real life, and being real. Raw and unfiltered. My kombucha, which is good for you. And I never want to make my subscribers feel like you owe me something or that my problems are your problems. If you decide to give me something or you want to donate something to my channel, you can do that on your own. I will not be asking you to like my videos or like anything. I won't be asking you to subscribe to my channel. If you happen to come upon this channel, welcome. I hope you like it. I hope you like the content that I'm going to be putting out. I did private the videos on this channel because it was a workout channel, but I'm just going to leave it as Black's Little Journey. And I will be having my Motivational Mondays, but I didn't put one up yesterday. My Black's Kombucha, Real Raw and Unfiltered, on Tuesdays, because this was the original one was Talk About It Tuesdays, and that's what we're doing today. We're talking about, we're just shooting the stars. I don't curse. I try not to, and I want to keep this channel profanity free and drama free. I don't know how that would stay, but I'm asking God to order my steps and keep me on the good path, on the old path, and do it the old ways and try to stay on that path and not come out of character. Because there's a lot of things going on at YouTube and it seems to be escalating, and I don't want to say anything or do anything. I'm doing this today, but I won't be putting anything up on this channel until after the 21st, because it's going to get nasty. From now until the 21st, probably up until Christmas, it's going to be a lot of mudslinging and mud puddle diving, and I want no parts of that. And I just want to keep it clean and keep it cute over here. No mud puddles and no waddling in mud for me. And I hope not for you, because I'm just asking you out there in the YouTube streets, don't get caught up in the chaos and take everything with a grain of salt, because people are building and stacking up their checks for the 21st. Believe that. Believe that. Believe that. Yeah. Real cute. But just be watchful. It's gonna be a lot of entertainment. Just put it like that. Between now and the 21st, you can look for a lot of fireworks and a lot of mud pies and a lot of mud slinging. And if you're into that, enjoy. Me, I'm not. I got other things to do, like Christmas cookies and baking stuff and doing little projects. The baby's not here, and I'm trying to get caught up on everything. As you can see, I mopped the floors. I mopped them twice. I have pizza ready for him. And I forgot to put this in the water. So after I finish this video, I'm just making this channel. Whoever finds me from the old channel, welcome. And if you follow the blue star. But I think YouTube's probably going to throw this into my algorithm, because I have two other channels. If not, I told y'all to follow the blue star. So if you follow the blue star, you'll find my new channel. You'll find me. And I'll say it again, welcome. And I can't wait to start bringing you guys content. Milwaukee is small, but it's a beautiful city. And I want to take y'all on that journey with me and help you discover the beautiful things that are here in Wisconsin. Yes, it's cold, but I enjoy that cold. I can't wait to play with my toy. You'll see more videos about my toy. Wait, hold on, y'all. I gotta take this call. That was some more bad news, but it's good news, because it's another thing that I don't have to worry about anymore. I'll talk about it later, but it's just like, I'm so tired of being stressed out, y'all. Yeah, if y'all only knew what I'm going through with these two boys, a 15-year-old and Dwayne just turned 3. And just the stubbornness and not wanting to listen on both parts. And it's been a battle, but I'm going to win, because my God is an amazing God. They just don't know that, but they're going to learn today. And I ain't going to keep y'all long. I know I've been talking and talking and talking. I just want to tell y'all, be careful out here in these YouTube streets and enjoy the shenanigans, because they're coming. I just don't want to be a part of it. And I will start uploading after 21st. I probably will have some content that I'll be working on and cleaning out my computer, because he killed the other raggedy computer. It's dead. It won't even come on. So my brand new Acer and my other HP, they're officially dead. I'm going to try to take the hard drives off of them and wipe them, but they won't even come on, so I don't even know how I'm going to do that. I'll probably go on YouTube and see how to get them out of there and take the information off of them, but they're gone. And I got to protect this one from them, because this is my last working computer. And probably just go and buy me a brand new computer, something that works for like people who need a lot of memory. Because that's what I seem to run into with these computers, is memory. And I have to buy those external memory drives. And if you drop them one time, they're basically done and all your information is lost. So I would like to have it on my computer and backed up in a hard external one that's more sturdy than the ones that I've been using. But the good ones are over $100, so I'll probably save and do that. And get all my ring lights and my tripods and stuff together, so I can make my videos and vlog with more fluidity than what I've been doing, because just like I don't have everything organized, and that would be nice. And I found this. The baby just loves it. My kids were fascinated because my grandmother had some coffee tables and the end table that were made out of this resin with these shells. And it's handmade in California with abalone shells taken by divers from the Pacific Ocean. Her tables were made out of this, and we lost them in a fire. And I don't know if I showed y'all this. It was at the Goodwill for $5. And it reminds me of her tables. And I just use it when I'm sitting here because this is glass, my desk, and I don't want it to crack. So I put my teacup on here. And I bought me some more teacups. Y'all see my little teapots up here, and I don't be using them. Like, I found this one that says hello there, and this one just has flowers on it. But look, it has a little butterfly in there, and I thought that was so pretty. And then, y'all know about this one. This is one of the other teacups that I bought, so I've just been stocking them right here out of the way because I don't want anybody to crack me. Every time I put them in the kitchen, they crack my little teacups. So I want to start using my teapots. And I know, and I found this book about herbs. It's just so much that I want to take. It's so many different directions that I want to take this channel. And like, I'm starting back with one. And I have one subscriber, and I love you and thank you for subscribing to my channel, whoever you are. I think you're my daughter, Roz, though. Hey, Roz. But if you're not, whoever you are, welcome. And it's just so much that I wanted to show y'all, and it's just you and me, kid. And I don't care if there's nobody else that ever joins. I'm just happy to start over without the chaos and stuff that was on my other channel, and take y'all with me on this journey. And I remember on my old channel, I had some iridescent pink lip gloss. I think it's from 2000, and it started 2019, 2020, and it was so pretty, and I can't find it, and I had it for a long time. But it lasts a long time. But today I have this one on. It's almost the color, that pink lip gloss, but I cannot find it. Because I really love lip glosses. I'll show you my collection one day. It is a huge collection of lip gloss and lipstick. And I haven't been up in my makeup room, so maybe one of these days we can go up there for a tour and put on some makeup and some eyelashes, because it's like all my lipstick, my wigs, my makeup, my eyelashes. And I really, if y'all watch that Luxe beauty supply store that used to be the old Lena's on 48th and Burleigh, it's this blue and gray and white wig. And that I almost went and bought that wig today, but I had to stay here because I was waiting for a call, and they were going to drop off the baby, and they said no. So I was going to go to Lux and buy that wig. It's blue. If you look at that video, it has like different colors streaked in it. And something said, why are you going to buy a wig with straight hair? Your hair ain't straight. And I put my dreadlocks back on after I cut them off and let my hair grow back and get healthy, because I dyed my hair blue, and they said don't never dye your hair blue with dreads because the roots, and they did break off. I don't know what my head looks like, y'all. You have to excuse me. But I said, why can't I just dye my ends blue like the wig? Why do I gotta wear a wig when I can dye my hair blue? It's half white anyway. And that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get me different colored blue dyes and dye the ends of my dreadlocks. They were blue. I don't know if they're still blue. But they're the same color as that wig. So why should I spend $70 on a straight wig? My hair, I'm not Caucasian. I'm black. And keep it Afrocentric. I'm not white. My hair didn't come out of my head straight. So I love that wig, but I love the colors. And I said, I'm not going to spend those $70 for that wig. But I sure was going to go buy it today. But a little voice said no. So I'm going to just dye my hair the same color as that wig and try to go back and find me some pink lip gloss. Maybe some hair bonnets and some stuff to keep my eyebrows on fleek. But no, I'm not going to buy that wig. It was beautiful. It was a lot of beautiful wigs in that store. And she is so nice. She is so sweet, and she just wants people to come in her store and feel comfortable. My mom went and found her. She likes to wear her hair blonde, and she found her a blonde wig that looks like micro braids, that's like a lace front. And I saw pictures, and it looks like she got her hair braided, and it's a wig. I was like, wow. And it like comes down to past her shoulders, so it has to be over 26 inches. I couldn't imagine how much you paid for that wig, but y'all, I'm rambling, and I gotta go because I have a meeting. Some people are gonna come over here to talk about something, and Snoop Dogg over there ran off on me. He's making all them howling sounds, and when I took the garbage out, he shot outside, and I could not catch him. I could not make him come in the house. And about 3 o'clock in the morning, he just sitting there standing at the door looking like a man, H-O-E, with a suit on. That's what people said I should name him Tuxedo, because it looks like he has a suit on. Just sitting there, meow. Like, I was like, I'm not finna go through this with you, boy. I'm not finna keep chasing you around. So tomorrow morning, he is getting snipped. They said they will be here to pick him up. They're going to do that. They're going to vaccinate him. I think they're going to clip his claws, give him a checkup, and they will be having him back by 3 p.m. So he can say goodbye to his testicles. Hold on to him, because they're going to be gone tomorrow. I'm sorry. I don't want him to be outside. I don't want him to come back. Like right now, he likes to get in my bed. He's mad because I won't let him get in my bed because he's been out all night and he got probably fleas on him. And I don't want no flea infestation, so I'm going to let him go to the doctor tomorrow and try to keep him in here and try to cool his jets, pump his brakes, drain his gas tank, because he is doing too much. And it's just because he's going through puberty, and I don't want him to start spraying, and I don't want him to be out here running the streets and get hit by a car or something. So I'm trying to do the right thing. So yeah, I ain't gonna keep you any longer. I know this is well over 30 minutes. Is it? Probably it's 11:11. The other one was probably 11 minutes or more too. So y'all, with that, I bid you adieu. I hope that you found this channel well and that God has blessed you. And I will see you the next time. Remember, I'm not going to upload anything until after them people over there get paid so they can stop the theatrics and don't accept no wooden nickels. And take everything with a grain of salt. And I will see you next time. I know you caught that. I love you. Deuces.